Tracy broke it back in that third spot as Nathaniel Younker now looks to become the third Sutphin winner in as many races as first time competition, but Codey's got other ideas. And that 88 car, he is now moved up into second. Reed is third. Fisher to the inside of Sutphin. He wants the number four spot. And a spinner! A total hard hit in turn number four. Slowly lost it and right in the path of Lincoln Sutphin, who plowed him down in turn number four. Leader in second place as Keith Reed works it back into turn number three and four and looks to check in for a second Pierstock victory of the season. Keith Reed off of turn number four, taking the Pierstock makeup feature event tonight here at Hagerstown. 31 of Nathaniel Younker gets the victory. Going to be Stoner in second, Diehl holding on for third. Smith and Schneider will round out to top five in the second and final Simulate qualifier. Megan Van and Jared Edwards, a pair of Southern Maryland Great Lake Model racers, and that lead, 3-5 battle, Black Pfizer, another fair spot. Good battles all the way through the field right now. Van and Edwards side by side for the lead. Edwards on the high side, Van hugging that guardrail down to the bottom, and back behind him, some other 2x2 racing, still tied on the third. Schneider, Michael Nichols in fourth. It's going to be Diehl and Smith now beginning the battle. Smith in that 59 started back in eighth position. He's trying to make a little noise up in the top five likewise. So get on to Ryan Smith, the driver of Asper's, Pennsylvania, the 59. As he works on Greg Diehl in the S7, they remain side by side. That is the biggest battle on the racetrack, just inside or at the top five position. That would be battling for fifth. Stoner meanwhile back to the stripe. 9 laps are complete. He continues to have a good edge over Wilson. Likewise for Wilson over Giesemann. And then Ron Nichols, and then we're back to that fifth place battle. And again, it continues to be Smith working down low. Diehl up high, and Diehl's got the edge. As Nichols drops back into sixth, but all the while, Jason Stoner looking to check in for victory number three of the racing season. Jason Stoner in Simulate action. Dylan Wilson comes in second. Greg Diehl, Lincoln Schneider, and Jason Giesemann. He grabs the lead from Brenneman. Brenneman right now in third, looking for it. Then the end of Brandon. Looks like Hart's going to cut him off down the back straightaway, and all this is doing is giving Trent Brenneman a big cushion and his first late model sportsman win at Hagerstown for 2023. Dillon comes up in second, following the line up third, Ryan Zipkin, Barry Moore, will be your top five. Outside, grabbing third, Younkers and Reed will go side by side, but Reed's going to have a high side edge. Coming back to lap number 9, we have got great battles out of the top 5. Again, a drag race back to the strike with the youngster Reed. We'll watch him go back into turn number 1 and 2. Good clean racing between these two drivers as well. A lot of respect as they easily can be beaten and banging on one another, but some good hard side by side racing. Younker draws even this time, heading to turn number 3. He'll hug that bottom guardrail. Reed will drift high. Younker trying to gain control, but again, Reed still has the slightest of edges back to the stripe. Reed is the leader, but here comes Fogle. Pulling in momentum, and they make him 3 wide into turn number 1 and 2 and 2. Younker down low. Fogle powers by Reed, and now Fogle's got the lead. The 8 of Reed is fading on the final lap as we look it back into 1 and 2. Younker diving down low. It's Fogle. Younker drag race back to the straight. And Nick Fogle in a backup car of Burrow Town comes away with the victory. He's behind. Trevor Collins has got the biggest smile on the racetrack with nobody around him all the way around. And the state of Delaware goes 2 for 2 in great late model action. Joe Warren on night 1, Trevor Collins on night number 2 for the